Welcome back to this week's edition of the BarroomBlitz.com. Taped live in front of a beer drinking audience here at Casey's. We're enjoying icy cold Bud Lights. We're talking hockey tonight. It's in the middle of June. We got a special panel tonight. I got my regulars over here on the side. We got Glenn Cheeks Killer. We got Domorama. We got Dougie floating around the crowd. But we got Dave the Hammer Schultz, Bob the Hound Kelly, Bill Clement. What's your nickname, Bill?
I didn't have a nickname.
What's that?
Headley.
Headley. And we got Brian Startare here from 610 WIP.
Cheeks, you should have brought your helmet.
Fired up. FlyerFanbook.com. We're getting fired up. Before we get started with the Flyers, right now we're putting it off and stuff like that. Fighting in the NHL. They want to try to get rid of it. How's it going to work, Dave?
Get rid of it.
Get rid of it.
Well, who's going to... Somebody's going to get hurt. That's what's going to happen.
Tonight?
I'm serious. These guys are 6'5", 6'6", 6'7", 260 pounds. I mean, and they train. They train to fight. They train to give good punches. I mean, I never did that in my life.
Right.
So somebody's going to get... You can build big muscles. Can you build bigger jaw bones? And, you can't. So somebody's going to get killed.
I don't think you could take fighting out of the game. I think if you let the players police themselves a little more, you won't have as many of these altercations like this. I think a lot of guys get away with it because they know the armor is thick anymore. I mean, when you guys played the game, what did you have? A couple Cooperalls, right? I mean, barely any equipment at all. These guys come in with these plastic...
What the hell's a Cooperall?
Well, whatever. I'm talking about the equipment. Tell me the equipment today. These guys feel like they're invincible with the shields and the hard plastic and all the stick work they have. Let the guys police themselves. I guarantee you wouldn't see as many fights.
Change the instigator rule, I think. Put take that away. Let the players please be accountable for themselves.
Yeah.
I think it goes away.
But I don't have a problem with taking the instigator penalty away either. I think the term enforcer... was
Cooperall.
It really describes what the guys do that are the tough guys. They enforce a code of conduct on the ice. Because you got 160-pounders like Danny Briere going up against 250-pounders,
right.
240-pounders. So you have to do something besides the rules to calm the gorillas down.
Okay.
Like Davey was one of those gorillas.
So if you couldn't fight, what do you think you would have done?
I was 195, 6'1". I was a gorilla. I'm talking about guys who are 2'6", or 6'6", 260 pounds, and they can hardly play the game. Some of them are actually, I shouldn't say that, because some of them have great talent.
Right.
But what is a guy who's 6'6", 260 that can hardly play, what does he do? How does he earn his $600,000 a year?
Whatever he wants.
Don't the enforcers take on themselves?
He's got to fight. He's not allowed, with the instigator rule, he's not allowed to... go after somebody that who we should go after. Mm-hmm. So they have their little tips, I'm going like someone else said, when they have that break about the 8-minute mark, mm-hmm. that's when they should have a fight, because then I know I won't go to the bathroom, I won't miss the fight. Right? instead of going like, you want to go?
Do you think one of the, they always say that people, the marginal, the purists love the game. People that love the game and from the 70s and 80s and started to go a little bit tighter in the 90s. But they say a lot of people are turned off by the game because it's violent. Do you guys believe that?
No. Not hockey fans.
That's what I'm saying. But the outside, the people.
The fringe guys.
The people that you're trying to bring in, the people you're trying to make it maybe a dent into the NBA or Major League Baseball.
Well, you know what they need to do? They need to get to the game and see it when it's live.
Absolutely.
And all of a sudden the crowd just flips the switch and everyone goes, absolutely.
They're all Democrats.
Political here.
Your cue, Dom. Your cue.
Don't the enforcers go after each other? Like the Cody and Brashear, they went after each other. It wasn't...
Why?
No, but it wasn't Brashear going after Briere.
Why? Why did they go after each other? Because one of them said something nasty to the other?
Well, I don't know. But it's not the smallest guy versus the largest
never
guy.
Was. Never
right,
was.
Right, so, I mean, wouldn't you just keep it in the game then?
Well, get rid of the instigator rule.
Right, well, I'm fine with that, but...
Well, that's not going to happen.
Well, but you're not going to get rid of fighting, though, are you?
Yeah.
I just don't see it.
Yeah, it's gone.
Well, it's not completely gone.
It's basically gone.
Yeah, well, then take away their instigator rule.
It's not gone. No, fighting was way up.
That would bring fighting back.
Davey, fighting was way up this year.
Yeah, the majors were actually up this
year. Well, yeah, two guys who make 600 to $1 million
I think what Davey,
who are tough guys, they have to fight.
I think where Davey's trying to come from, hockey's an emotional game. Two guys go out there and they bang around. You know, we used to go out there bang around and then fights would ensue because you make contact, you know, stuff. What Davey's saying now is that what happens,
they go out
fighting isn't really part of the game. You know, like you said, Riley goes out there, LaRocque goes out there, hey, you want to fight? You want to fight? Yeah, I'll give you a shot at me. Two guys square up, they fight. Doesn't necessarily change the tempo of the game where a fight in the old days would change. The intimidation was more. There's no intimidation today because you can't catch Danny Briere. You can't spear him. You can't do anything. All you can do is say, look, I'm not going to fight you. You go over to Briere and you say to him, every time the star touches the puck, we're going to run you. But, you know, we can't do much like that. So
I agree with your saying, Bob, about the fact that you can't touch those guys anymore because of the rules that are in place. But if
never
you look back, if you look back at the game the Flyers had lost, it's an improvement.
Did you ever see Guy Lafleur get someone go after
him? No, I'm talking about a purpose of a game, though. There's a purpose in the game not to go out there and just start a fight. If you look at what the Penguins did in Game 6, who fought Carcillo? His name escapes me now. But
Talbot.
Flyers were up 3-0.
To score two goals.
Right? And Maxime Talbot fights Daniel Carcillo. Carcillo was vilified for taking him on, but they looked at that point and said, listen, this is where the fighting is involved in the game. It's to spark your bench. It's to say, listen, we're not going away. If you keep it in the game where it has its role and not so much sending your enforcer out there just for the sake of a fight, then I think it still has its place in the game. It changes the tempo of the game. At least that's what I believe.
You think when Carcillo won the fight that it would energize the building. Still, we're up 3-0. All of a sudden, we just caved and fell apart. So,
right.
I mean, it shouldn't have worked in reverse, but, man, it just sucked the air out of that building.
It did.
It did.
All right.
That's bizarre.
So did we answer your question?
No, you still need fighting in hockey.
Absolutely. Absolutely you do.
Right, so you don't get rid of fighting.
It's the rules around the fighting.
You want to get rid of something, get rid of the shootout. Get rid of the shootout. That's what you can get rid of.
Get rid of the shootout, get rid of the regulation tie.
Yes.
Well, the overtime.
Either you win the game or you don't.
Yeah, you got to
go. You don't get that extra point for nothing.
Forget the ties. The shootout's okay. You just can't give a point for a loss.
Right. You get a point for nothing. If they win the game in the shootout, give them the 3 points, and then you end up.
I just don't see how you can reward a team sport. You go 65 minutes, and then all of a sudden you're going to give another point for a bunch of individual plays. I mean, that's ridiculous. The Flyers have lost a division like that to the New Jersey Devils because their shootout record historically
stinks.
Has been so poor. I mean, it's a joke. The shootout is a gimmick to get those fringe fans back into the seats. And to me, I mean, you can't give a point out there for a singular effort. It's a team game.
Well, that's why the races are so tight coming down the end because you're getting a point.
Everybody's in there, right?
Everybody keeps getting a point. Like you said, you lose, you get a point. You keep moving up. If you got
how many
two,
points did you get?
we got an awful lot as a team.
I mean, Bill, you covered the game. I mean, do you think the shootout's good for the game?
Absolutely.
You do? I disagree.
You know why? But you talked about fringe fans.
And that's what you want.
The future fans that can afford tickets, and obviously it's a business at some point. Kids love the shootouts.
Yeah,
kids love the shootouts.
You know what the shootout was when we were kids? It was the Pepsi shootout. It was Peter Puck between periods. I used to love that between periods.
It means your show's delayed another 5 minutes before you get to talk. That's what your problem is. 5 minutes later you're
home. Why not increase
the overtime? It's extra work,
Tim.
It's extra
work. What's that,
Tom? Why not increase the overtime? It's 5 minutes.
You can't have games going to 11.
Well, do 10 minutes. What's 5 more minutes?
10 minutes of 4-on-4, I think, would be a great answer.
Right, because
it's too long. All you got to do is start 4-on-4, and the first any time after 2 minutes in overtime, at that first whistle after 2 minutes, you go to 3-on-3.
Okay, well, that's another angle to go at.
Well, that's a hockey angle. For everybody that says shootout's a gimmick, you want to play? Well, go to 3v3.
I just don't like changing. I just don't like changing the actual game. You're charging.
But you like ties?
But you're charging $85 a ticket, Bill. $85. People were in their seats watching 60 minutes of great hockey. Then you're telling you, okay, we're gonna go back to 4-on-4 for 5 minutes, which is fine. But you know it's still exciting. And then you're gonna tell me to go to 3-on-3 or a shootout. I don't mind a tie. I don't. Flyers went 35 games without losing.
And then you got to take a look
get
at.
A point for a tie.
You got to take a look. Yeah, but you know what?
There it is. Well,
I like. I don't mind
get
ties.
Don't get a point.
They get points for everything in hockey.
Yeah, yeah. Well,
you
got to
get a point for a tie.
You shouldn't get a point for the loss.
How many points did
but
you
look,
get?
Next time. Next time there's a shootout. Next time there's a shootout. See how many people have left the building. See how many people are sitting down.
Well, see, then you're telling me it's a decision because of its marketing and money. And it's not, you know,
are you trying
to make the game better or you're trying to appease people to come in and watch? I think, to me, that's selling
out. What page is that on?
I'm just saying, I just think the shootout.
What happened to the hammer? Hey. What happened to the hammer and the hound show?
Let me tell you, I respect Bill Clement.
Get fired up.
I just don't like the shootout. Done. I don't like it.
Here, take that home. Your wife will be happy.
Hey.
Oh, man.
You know what? You're used to having a bump stop.
All right. Well, why don't we want to take a quick break. We're going to enjoy some quick...
Not right.
Grab yourself an icy cold Bud Light. We'll enjoy some more Barroom Blitz with the boys.
Hey, I'm telling you.